Okay, so welcome, Volker
Danke.
Dötzsch, at CancerCon 2014. And he came all the way from Frankfurt. And as I heard, it's not your first time in India, but it's certainly your first time in southern India, as I heard.
Correct.
So, and we've been here now for like more than 2-3 days. So what's your resume so far?
Oh, it's fantastic, say so. It's always easy. The food is fantastic. The climate at the moment is super. It's quite ugly, cold and gray in Frankfurt. So I really enjoy the nice warm weather. It's like early spring here and it's not too hot, not too cold, not rainy. It's really fantastic.
So it's also the perfect setting for a meeting like CancerCon 2014. Because we have a broad range of scientists and clinicians, especially, that all come together to discuss the science and obviously also the improvements or the questions we need to find an answer to in order to combat cancer. And how do you so far perceive the interaction also between the clinicians and the basic researchers?
I think, first of all, it's very important to have this sort of interaction. And it has become, at this conference, I think, very, very clear where the direction will go. Everyone is talking about this personalized medicine, and here you have seen that for the first time how this will probably be implemented, that a patient sample will be screened, will be sequenced with all the fast and not so expensive sequencing facilities now available. I think it becomes really realistic that you can start with a certain treatment, then continue to follow the changes in the unstable genome of these tumors and then react to this. I think this is fantastic news for the future because one can in more or less real time almost react to what the tumor is doing and so try to stay ahead of tumor or to perceive what's going to happen and then adapt the therapy according to these developmental evolution experiment that tumors really are. And so I think this has become really clear here, and there was a really good discussion between the clinicians and the basic researchers along those lines.
Yeah, and what's also important, you already mentioned the accessibility to tumor sample tissue from real patients, and there has been a lot of things done. Also the IIT now established a tumor tissue data bank, and how do you think with all the technology that is now available and all the sequencing, structural biology, computational biology, so there has been enormous progress within the last 10, 15 years. So, but nevertheless, all we need in the end of the day is the tumor samples from patients. And so how do you think it's going to be in the future, whether we will have access to it more frequently and like, because that's what I heard at least, it's not always easy to obtain tissue samples. So, because then I guess it's easier to use all this technology that is available to make use of it and also the findings one finds to have it publicly accessible also for people all over the world. So how far are we from this dream of...
How far we are, I don't know, but I think the direction has become very, very clear. And what is currently being done here in India with setting up of this tissue bank is a very, very important contribution to this. I think the talk by Richard Murray made it very clear, really brought it to the point, that if you have certain types of tumors, treatment will lead to secondary tumors or will select secondary mutations probably. And we need a lot of statistics. So it becomes also clear that if you have a melanoma or a lymphoma, then there will be certain routes. Not everything is possible, but only certain things will happen. And we have to really figure out what happens in specific cancers and how they will develop to stay ahead of the cancer. And with all the sequencing facilities, with all the tissue data banks available, we will have the information at some time to statistically anticipate what a tumor is doing, and then with sequencing also confirm this, and then really stay in the game and have a better treatment for patients.
Yeah, and probably also share all our information that we gained
that
from
is
it.
Necessary. Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
And your research is quite structural based, because actually, in the end of the day, the structure tells us a lot. I mean, the structure of certain proteins tells us a lot about their characteristics and maybe also potential therapeutic agents or targets. So can you just in simple words describe a little bit what your lab is specifically focusing on and why?
Okay, I'll try. So we really try to understand the regulation of activity by looking into the structure. And it's not only the structure of individual domains, but it becomes clear that a lot of proteins are built up of multiple domains. And how these domains interact with each other within one protein or with other proteins is how regulation is taking place. And in the past decades, structural biologists have more looked into individual domains, and we have now big databases. There we have already databases to basically know more or less every single structure of every single domain in humans. What is now becoming far more important is how these domains interact with each other, and this is what we're trying to build, for example, in the P63 case. But you need not only structure, you need also biophysical methods to look into so-called weak interactions, because a lot of these regulatory events are driven not by a strong interaction, where you have a complex and that is rock solid, but these are weak transient interactions. And for this, we still have to develop also technology to characterize them, because they are also extremely important in this entire process.
Yeah. Okay, so what we take home from this is that there is still a lot to do, but we are probably on the right track, right, all together. And thanks, Volker, for having you here on this CancerCon meeting, and hope to see you next year.
I hope so, yeah. Thank you.
Okay.